like I said, like I was telling some students yesterday, I told them, I said, what inspired me into engineering is when I worked on a black and white TV. In the olden days, we used to have a black and white TV with the doors and all that. And there was a day I actually wanted to watch a very important program, and the TV wasn't working. And I, you know, worked on the TV and it started working. And I said, well, what profession will, you know, work on the repairs? And they said engineering. And I said, I want to study engineering. And I went all out to ensure that I study engineering, because the first admission I got was in mathematics in UNILAG. And I said, no, I don't want to study mathematics. A lot of people came and told my parents at that then that, see, there are not so many females in engineering. It's not good for her to go into engineering. Let her go and do the mathematics. I said, no, I want to study engineering, and I'm going to study engineering. And I thank God that today I studied engineering. In my class in school, I was the only female there. And I had lots of boys, and my parents were, you know, they were really upset that you are the only female in your class. I said, it doesn't matter. I'm studying what I want to study. And I'm happy today that I've studied that. I'm also the first female engineer to become the chairman of the Nigerian Institution of Mechanical Engineers in Lagos. Looking at the gender, you know, like I said, when I was in school, I was the only female in my class. And, you know, in engineering, you have to do technical drawing. And you have to carry the board, carry the T-square and all that. And then we also had to do the practicals, the foundry, the machining and all that. Some of those things were quite challenging for me because they were basically men. But because I'd made up my mind, I wanted to do that. One of the challenges I also had was in welding. You know, because welding is basically, you know, the sparking of light and all that. And, you know, at the time that I did welding so much, I had all my skin black, my hands were black. I had to go to the optician to, you know, clean my eyes, you know, and all that. So it's quite challenging, but if you are determined to excel in whatever you do, you will definitely excel in it. All you need to do is to keep your dreams alive. All you need to do is to aspire to get to greater heights of wherever you find yourself. And if you continue to make those two things your watchword, that you want to actualize your dreams and you want to be able to excel, then you will excel. Now, there are so many challenges out there for women when it comes to engineering, because if you look at the percentage of women in engineering, it's far, you know, below average to the population of the men. It's a male-dominated field. But if you're a woman and you find yourself there, you know, some of the challenges as women, okay, but like somebody like me have 4 children, you know, I have to also bring them up, and I also have to do my own profession. So because of that, you know, a lot of women that are not bold, I'm sorry to say, cannot be in engineering, because it's about being able to work, and it's about being able to run your work-life cycle. And that is your life, your marriage, and your work. You must be able to combine the three together. As a mother, I stand for my children. As a wife, I stand for my husband. As, you know, an engineer, I must also do my work. But I've been able to overcome, you know, when I got into the industry, after I left school, I'd gone through the rigors of school. Well, you know, engineering is a profession that exposes you to practicals. From the practicals, you know, during the IT and all that, I've been able to know that, you know, engineering is about practicals, and you must be able to withstand the pressure that comes with it. Although there are discriminations, I wouldn't say they are not. There are discriminations, oppositions, you know, from parents. You know, in the olden days, when we were born, we had lots of parents that would say, your child is either a lawyer or a doctor. You know, those were the two key professions at that time. And if you say engineering and everybody looks at you like, you are going to be dressing like a mechanic and all that. You know, but when I started, I looked at myself that, see, this thing I've chosen, when it's moving is engineering, when it's working is engineering, you know, and engineering makes a difference in every nation that wants to develop. And I said, I want to be part of that change. I want to be part of that development. And because of that, I put in all out that I must do it. I've had opposition basically in all ways, including the societies that we belong to. That's the professional bodies that we belong to. They feel that women, you can hold other positions, but not the chairmanship position. You know, they don't want women to be there. They feel, why? We are more than women here, and we should be the ones. You have your own society, which is the Association of Professional Women Engineers. Go and be in your association. But we feel that we can make a difference. And I want to say that in the last 1.5 years that I've been the chairman, even they themselves say, I'm a lion, you know, leading ships. Opportunities are there for women if they enhance it. You know, if you look at most of the women that are in engineering, some of them had had to take banking jobs. Some of them have taken other jobs because they feel that they don't want to stay in engineering again. But I feel that personally, nobody should be a pushover. You shouldn't allow anybody to push you out of what you have chosen for yourself, which is that engineering. Because a lot of the times, you know, when women in their place of work, they get frustrated and they tend to move out. And that's why, I think, was it 2 years ago, I delivered a paper, you know, moving out of the shadows. Because women, we have to move out of the shadows when it comes to engineering. In school, you know, I've had to challenge men. You know, some men, they are engineers like myself. They challenge me. They say, I have somebody like you at home. You are a wife. So I have somebody like you. I say, you can't have somebody like me at home. The person that is married to me is also an engineer. He respects me. I respect him as co-professionals. But when we get home, he's my husband. I respect him as my husband. My children respect the two of us as both engineers and providers for the home. So you have to be able to stand your ground and know exactly what you want to do with your life. But presently, I can say that women are given opportunities if they actually enhance them. Because I know a lot of women that are into construction. I know a lot of women that are into what I do, which is mechanical engineering. I know a lot of women that are into power, that are into electrical engineering, and they are doing so well. You know, just last week, I read 40 successful women in engineering in America, and they are doing so well. You know, the ones that work in Google, that do the application and all that, they are basically women, and they are successful. They are doing so well. The one that is heading Apple is a woman. So how much more we are here? We have to enhance those things. We have to move out of the shadows and explore and make ourselves known. And I believe that as we go on, we'll continue. You know, the few people that are ready, the others will begin to join us. Like for me, I personally feel that for women to actually develop and enhance themselves in the in this engineering profession, you need to start from the scratch. And that is the girl child. We need to start from the girl child and ensure that young ladies, young girls from secondary school begin to know the importance of being able to study engineering, the significance of being able to make a difference, you know, because engineering is not only about physical aspect of it. We have the intellectual aspect, we have the analytical aspect of it, we have the creative aspect of it, and once you begin to explore, there are so many aspects of engineering that women can actually flow in and, you know, be successful in. And we need to start from the girl child. We need to look at scholarship for, you know, the tertiary institutions, begin to encourage women to go into it. I like one of the things that federal government started recently. I was able to know about it because my daughter is a beneficiary of it. You know, they chose about 5 lady girls that scored the highest in JAMB, and they are giving them scholarship every year throughout their school, which means that even the government themselves recognize that women must also excel. And that means it's in the hands of the women to actually feel that they have empowered themselves to actually make it. If we are looking at Nigeria and we are looking at the engineering profession, we are still very far behind. You know, when it comes to the engineering profession, we are still far behind. And because of the roadblocks, you know, the society itself does not encourage, they have the wrong perspective of females in engineering. And of course, in recent times, especially in all our various professional bodies in engineering, the women that have been at the ends of affairs have actually been able to make a lot of difference. And because of that, it's like it's choking for the men that, oh, all the women are making. Anytime you find a woman as chairman, they tend to make a lot of difference beyond you know, what some of the men have been able to do. So it's choking, but I will still encourage women. Let's be there to make a difference. Let's be there to excel. Let's be there to enhance. And let's be there to actually, you know, celebrate ourselves. Okay, for the young ones, what I feel personally is we need to catch them young. And one of the things that we do as women engineers that we do already, we go to their schools to give them career talks. We, you know, we explain engineering to them. You know, like just yesterday, I was at Lagos City College to speak to the students about engineering, why they should study engineering, what they need to, you know, excel in engineering, and how they need to take a personal decision. And also, we have scholarship scheme for them, you know. Then we do a secondary school project competition for them, wherein, last year, we brought in, we gave them projects on wind energy, and they were able to couple them, and, you know, actually, somebody was able to win, one school was able to win. So those are some of the things that we are doing to pick their brains in engineering to ensure that, you know, the ones that are actually interested in studying engineering actually do so and follow up with them. Then one of the other things that we also do for them, you know, for people that aspire to be engineers, is to mentor them. We have various mentorship programs that we have created for them, you know, just to encourage them. But I feel one of the things that we actually might need to begin to do is to begin to talk to parents. One of the things that discourage people, you know, when I wanted to study engineering, I'm an example of that. When I wanted to study engineering and I said I wanted to do mechanical engineering, you know, some people that were close to my parents that are also into engineering, they said, no, why does she want to do mechanical? Mechanical is the hardest out of all the engineering. It's the most physical out of all the engineering. That, no, let her go and do electrical, or let her go and do computer engineering. No. Mechanical, I said, no, that is what I want to do. Because, and the reason why I chose mechanical is because it encompasses all the other arms of engineering. Under mechanical, you find automobile, you find the refrigerator, the air conditioners, the marine engineering, the aeronautic, you know. It's all encompassing. And I said, no, that's what I want to do. And they said, no, they have witnessed some people that machine has held their clothes, their hands have been cut off, and they can put your hand in my chair. I said, no, that's what I want to do. So I feel that we should begin to educate parents also to encourage their children if they want to actually study engineering. And I want to also encourage the young girls themselves. They can actually make a lot of difference. Like presently, I'm organizing an innovation challenge for students. I encourage females to submit because they can actually make a lot of difference. We shouldn't leave it all to the men. And you know, like what they say, what women see is wider than what a lot of men will see. So that means that we can actually make a lot of difference if we put our mind to it. Every other profession, if we are talking about bold for change, I feel that it's more about the inner man of each person, you know, to be able to make a difference. A lot of women are scared to face the men. I remember when I wanted to contest as chairman of Lagos chapter, a lot of people came to me and said, leave it for the men. I said, no, this is what I want to do now. And these are the things I want to do. And if I continue to sit on the line, I will not be able to make that difference. I will not be able to make that change. And that means I must be there. And I had so many oppositions, and I said, no. Even when I got in there, I still have lots of opposition. I still put my feet down. No, I'm still going to ensure that I do what is right. And I feel it's about yourself. You must be sure of yourself. That is one. You must have your dreams. What are your visions in life? What are the things that you want to achieve? How do you intend to achieve them? Have you created a scorecard for yourself for you to be able to tick some of the things that you begin to achieve? On your scale of preference, is excellence highest on your scale of preference? Those are some of the things that one should begin to look at. If you now look at those things and have, you know, your vision, okay, what is your vision for your life? What are your dreams? How do you intend to achieve them? You know, and you put them on a scale of 1 to 10, and you begin to take them off as you go on, I think women will be able to excel.